I actually don't like musicals. I don't like when people break into song in the middle, like, hello, I'm fine, how are you? That kind of stuff. I just don't feel it's grounded in any kind of reality, and I can't personally, you know, feel it. I can't personally kind of empathise with the story, because I just kind of think, who are these people, you know? I mean, it's fantastic, you know, for escapism and all that kind of stuff. And actually, in saying that, I adore Dancer in the Dark, you know, which is, I don't know if you'd call that a musical, though, you know, it's really turning it on its head and really raw. But we really wanted the music to be originally composed for the film. So we've like 50 pieces of music or something, but it was really important that they weren't pre-existing, so that it felt real. You know, it felt like it was coming out of the story and out of the characters more than anything. We were blessed with the cast, actually. Robin was attached before I was attached, actually. He had worked with the producer previously on a film called House of D. So he was already attached to play Wizard. And then I met Freddie, and that was an obvious kind of choice, you know. I met him, and he's just so kind of open himself as a person, and kind of fearless. So that was fantastic. He's almost like August, you know, in many ways. And then Johnny's Irish, so I knew Johnny, and we met up, and you know, he can sing and play, and that was one of the most important things, because I didn't want somebody conscious and worried about being in front of an audience and playing guitar, and it turns into a rock story and a music video that way, you know. So we needed someone who was confident doing that, so that they could just think about the acting, you know. And then Kerry has this kind of like this poise and elegance and gracefulness of, like, she used to be a dancer, you know, but she also has this steel spine, and that's really what we wanted for her character. We didn't want her like gazing out windows all day and looking beautiful, and, you know, we wanted her to kind of get kind of down and dirty, emotional and angry, which is interesting for a woman's character, I think. No, it was pretty full on. Kerry had to learn cello in a couple of weeks, so she had to learn the bowing, and so she was, you know, she went from, you know, nursery rhymes to Bach and Elgar in a couple of weeks. So she was practicing every day. It was quite a task. And then Freddie had to learn organ, guitar, and conducting. So he had three separate teachers, three separate coaches, and he wanted to actually do the conducting, because I said to him, look, August is mad, so he doesn't have to conduct like a conductor, you know, he doesn't have to know all of that stuff, like, I haven't a clue. And so Freddie said, oh yeah, okay, but I want to know it, so in order to throw it out, you know. So he wanted to learn the right way to do it, so that he could then kind of do the right way, but also mixed in with the madness, you know. So it was full on for the two of them, and Johnny could already play guitar, and Robin could already play harmonica, so... Yeah, I wouldn't be the biggest fan of techno, I suppose, you know. I like everything, actually. I mean, I love classical music. I love, you know, certain kinds of rap. I love punk. So I love, like, I just generally love music, you know. And I was just saying earlier, like, I came to it without any kind of theoretical background or any kind of intellectual background. So in many ways, I was... totally free to just turn things on their head, you know, because you don't have the weight of all that behind you. I'm sure the classical world might have been turning in their grave at some of the stuff we did, but, you know, that's what we wanted to do. Not initially. The Oliver Twist thing wasn't a big thing for me. That was actually more so for the producer, Richard Lewis. I think when he saw Oliver, it was a big thing for him. I think it was his first movie to see in the cinema or something like this, you know. So, but I loved the idea of this gang of kids, you know, in the middle of this derelict theatre. And I was, as much as possible, at every turn, we tried to make it as real and a bit more gritty, really, than I guess Oliver. Although Oliver's pretty gritty. I mean, you know, he kills your one Nancy in it and everything. So that was a movie that was able to kind of have, you know, kind of magic, and then have some real kind of heavy stuff in it as well, you know.